Andy, you're basically one of the best entrepreneurs I know, and you're also very broad. Obviously, you're in crypto, but you think about a lot of different things, and I think that like synthesis of all these different concepts from all these different places is what makes you from most entrepreneurs I know. And so with that, we're doing a startup competition, and so I'm wondering, like, from where you are in the space, but just generally as an entrepreneur, do you have any recommendations?
There's so much out there to work on. There's a bunch of frameworks you can use to think about this problem. One of them is you can look at and try and find where there's like severe customer need, right? Where people need something. And another one is you can look at where technology is evolving to a point where there's now new things that are enabled by the technology that you think could be really compelling products. One framework I love to think about these things in is that there's discussion about kind of three major secular tailwinds that can drive a business: economic, social, and technological tailwinds. And the most compelling businesses are found where there's an intersection or confluence of really powerful economic tailwind driving people towards this sort of solution, a really powerful social tailwind or cultural tailwind driving people towards a solution, and a really powerful technological tailwind driving people towards a solution. If I was working to build something on the DSO protocol, I was working to build it like the down the middle DSO social product, right? What I'd be saying, and I think this is true, is listen, economically, there's something really interesting happening, which is the cost of building things on chain is going down dramatically, right? That's a powerful economic tailwind for a new type of application to be built in a decentralized way. Socially, we are seeing an enormous backlash against centralized social media companies. That's the easy one for DSO, right? And technologically, there's this new way that you can build decentralized products without actually needing to be an expert in Solidity or Rust or whatever language. So that then points you to like pretty fertile ground, right? Where you're like, okay, all of these tailwinds are supporting me.